Tonight on Jewish Sports Legends.
His was a career which began with so much promise,
but would end in bitter disappointment. Jack Wasserman.
What happened? Born on February 26, 1997, to parents of tremendous athletic ability, there initially was great hope that Jack would become a sports legend worthy of the Wasserman family name.
Family historian, Eric Wasserman.
Considering the pedigree, everyone assumed Jack would be a tremendous athlete. Sutton, his mother, was originally a goy, so he was already halfway home at that point. Paul, his father, defined what it means to be a Jewish athlete in the tradition of Sandy Koufax, Kevin Youkilis, and Kyle Broslovsky.
Oh God, I'm so bored!
Unfortunately for Jack, it just didn't work out that way.
Parents Paul and Sutton Wasserman.
He had trouble with the most basic things.
Like eating.
Like standing and walking.
Yeah, so it seemed that athletics was pretty much out of the question.
Unwilling to concede defeat, the persevering parents tried to find a suitable sport so young Jack might achieve his genetic destiny.
We tried bowling, basketball, even golf. Nothing seemed to work.
So then we moved to Southern California and some kid he met talked him into playing baseball.
Yeah, when I first met Jack, well, I kind of felt bad for him because he had no idea how to play baseball. So I kind of took him under my wing and taught him how to play.
Under the tutelage of young Master Waltz, Jack grew into a formidable baseball player. Yet there was one attribute that he just could not control. An attribute that would lead to his eventual downfall and end his promising baseball career. Former Little League coach Neil Walker.
Yeah, Jack Wasserman. I remember him. He was a cocky smack talker. He would go on and on about how he could play better than any major leaguer out there. He'd tell me stories about Garret Anderson being lazy and how Eddie Guardado throws like a girl. I mean, this guy was so cocky, they had to ban him from Little League. It's a sad tale.
In a Jewish Sports Legends exclusive, former teammate Nico Guardado tells the inside story of who was really behind Jack's baseball banishment.
Yeah, Garret Anderson and my dad were behind Jack getting banned from baseball. You gotta understand. All Jack's talk about, my dad got back to him. So he decided to come down from the big leagues and pitch to Jack, just to shut him up. You know, teach him a little lesson. And well, it didn't go as planned.
Oh, nice!
My dad just lost it. He was never the same.
I'm pretty upset, you know what? And next thing you know, everybody's laughing and stuff, and I'm on the ground, dirt all over, and I'm supposed to be a major league pitcher. Hey, you Wasserman boy, you better stay off my lawn.
Garret Anderson.
You don't think smack talk gets back to us in the clubhouse?
All right, good job.
Next time I saw him, I threw him out from left field. So who's lazy now, Jack?
After he was banned from baseball, that was pretty much it for him.
Well, he did get a second degree black belt in jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, but he did have to quit after he killed that kid.
That's true.
So we've just really just come to accept that there'll never be a Wasserman who becomes a Jewish sports legend.
Wait, they said what? Idiots.
Okay, let's take 2 seconds to talk now about soccer, which is about 2 seconds longer than it deserves. Real men don't play soccer. And let's be honest, soccer just isn't important to anyone in this country. Let's leave it that way.
Go tell the world, tell it I'm on fire. My wings are burning, speak through me.
been here for too long. And now we're gone. Oh, so gone. So tell the world. Tell it to go on. Go tell it right. Circles and you, you're doing lines. Go tell the world. You stayed away too long, and now we're gone. Oh, so gone. So tell the world. Tell it to go. True.